Hi everyone. Today we are going to discuss the fundamentals of IR spectroscopy. Beginning to the lecture, if you like the lectures, like them, share them, subscribe them, and like the bell icon so that you may get the updates on my lectures. Okay. Coming to today's lecture. Now this is an IR spectroscopy, infrared, and this is also an electromagnetic radiation. So what happens here in this instrument is there is source used from incident radiation, that is in the region of IR rays of entire electromagnetic radiation. Only a part of IR rays are imprinted onto the sample when a molecule contains a permanent dipole. So the oscillating dipole in the molecule interacts with the incident IR rays. Now the vibrational infrared radiations as well as the dipole, when the frequency matches together, so what happened, there is an absorption of IR spectroscopy. So this is the fundamental pattern in IR. So in any electromagnetic radiation, the incident light interacts with sample, thereby characterization by using changes in the sample. So this IR spectroscopy is also an example of absorption spectroscopy. So this is a fundamental thing you need to know. Now coming to the instrumentation part. So in the current lecture we are only dealing with the instrumentation. In the forthcoming next lecture we will see the principle of IR spectroscopy. So what exactly the instrumentation says, that you have a source of electromagnetic radiation. What is the source? That is Nernst Glover or globular source. Now from this IR rays, infrared rays in the region of 2.5 to 15 microns, okay, will fall onto the sample, and there is a pattern of what the resonance between the permanent dipole and the incident infrared rays, which causes absorption of the incident infrared radiation. This is the fundamental. So what exactly the instrumentation is? We have a source of light, that is electromagnetic radiation, in the region of infrared rays, which before falling onto the sample, what happens here is you have a what called focusing. This is the focusing mirror. Now this electromagnetic radiation in the IR region, you have a baffle here. This baffle will imprint your electromagnetic radiation onto two different mirrors. So one mirror is your variable mirror, the other one is your fixed mirror. So what happens here in this, the total principle in this is, now the electron incident radiation will move with the variable or movable mirror as well as the fixed mirror. In doing so, what is the benefit we are getting is, there is a superimposition of waves leading to constructive interference and destructive interference in all the planes. That means in 360 degrees plane, you get both constructive and destructive interference. What is the benefit of doing this is, you get all the frequencies in the complete range. Suppose if you don't have this pattern of this thing in your instrumentation, so you need to, for each and every functional group, you need to imprint different frequencies electromagnetic. Whereas this one will facilitate that all the frequencies which might be present in the molecule are focused at a time onto the sample. This is the benefit of this part of your instrumentation. Now once there is a constructive and destructive difference, the complete frequencies will be fall under the focusing mirror. This focusing mirror will allow the radiations to fall onto the sample. Now sample, in the sampling pattern in IR spectroscopy is of two types. One is neat method. Second one is pellet or and nozzle mold method. In neat method, what do you mean by neat? There is no dilution, there is no mixing with anything. If you have a liquid sample, you take two different sodium chloride, two sodium chloride crystals. This is one crystal, you take one more crystal as such, you apply the sample, keep underneath the light, your lamp, you ensure that all the solvent evaporates. Now you keep the both the sodium chloride plates, fuse them and place into the instrument. This is called as neat method. The second method is pellet method. In pellet method, what you do, you take a minute amount of sample and mix with potassium bromide and make in a pellet or a tablet size, again that you place into the instrument. Next one is nozzle mold. For oily and viscous samples, you make that in a nozzle mold method. This is the fundamental of sample preparation. Now what happens, the incident infrared radiation, after having constructive and destructive interference, the complete functionalization of the complete frequency of waves will fall onto the either liquid sample or onto the pellet or onto the nozzle mold. Thereafter, after absorption of infrared radiation, why there is an absorption of infrared radiation? Because every molecule will have a functional oscillating dipole. Now there are two different IR vibration spectroscopy. One is infrared spectroscopy, which deals with the molecules which have a permanent dipole, and the next one is Raman spectroscopy, in which you do not require permanent dipole. That we will see in the next coming lecture. Now after absorption of infrared radiation, now there is an absorption and that is passed on to the detector. What type of detectors? Thermal conductor detectors, bolometers, and so many. So why the conventional UV detectors are not helpful in IR? This is a fundamental question you arise. So what is the difference between UV and IR is, the energy of infrared radiation which is causing absorption in a molecule is not sufficient to emit a photon. So if there is a photon, you can take photomultiplier tubes, thermal photoconductivity tubes, and you can multiply the photons and you can count number of molecules. Whereas in this technique, you lack energy in the infrared radiation in comparison with your UV. So what happens? You need to have a special techniques of detectors. So now that is again electronic. This is electronically viewed. Now here in IR spectroscopy, most of the students believe that it is given in the terms of transmission. No, in IR, the absorption of complete frequencies of IR waves will give an absorption spectrometers. We convert it into transmittance by doing Fourier transformation into transmittance. Now one more question arises, why we are not seeing the absorption spectra, why we are converting by Fourier transformation into a transmission spectra? See, all the functional groups have near absorption values. Suppose carbonyl, amine, OH, NH2, CH. These functional groups have a near absorption value, whereas when it is converted into transmittance value, the value is increases in number, which causes there is a wide separation. Now if you see the absorption spectra, all the three different groups, you take NH, OH, CH, almost all they clubbed in one single unit. Whereas if you see in the transmittance, the value is bigger and there is a wide separation between the this one. This is the fundamental information in what? Instrumentation of instrumentation part. In the next lecture we will see what we will see? We will see the principle in IR spectroscopy. Thank you.